bisexual as a word is 227 years old and it shows. It's worn, it's wrinkled, incontinent, it's been through various meanings and incarnations in many different languages, and yet, despite constant growing pains, it has endured. I want to say that the question of what bisexual means is more prominent now than ever before, but I don't actually think that's true. The dualistic nature of our traditional concepts of sex and gender has always meant the word bisexual was going to cause trouble. Maybe because it's a complicated word, maybe because it's just overly simplistic, and maybe because bisexuality is, by nature, just so damn disruptive. The earliest recorded use of the word bisexual was in 1793, referring to hermaphroditic plants, those which have both male and female sexy parts, not an uncommon thing in the realm of our leafy cousins. It appears that the urn is a bisexual flower, containing a capsule more or less pedunculated according to the length of the tube. How pedunculated is your tube? The root of the word, no pun intended, is bi meaning two and sexual referring to sexes. The plant is of two sexes. It did not mean, as is commonly believed today, I want to have sex with both a lady and a gentleman, although some plants of the Georgian era may have identified that way. The first recorded use of the word bisexual for humans referred to original humans being of both sexes. This, but little differing from Origen's interpretation or hypothesis, is supported and confirmed by the very old tradition of the homo androgynous, that is, that the original man, the individual first created, was bisexual. The idea is that humans were once homo androgynous, which is, as of this moment, absolutely my gender identity forever. As far back as Plato's Symposium, there has been this idea that humans may have once been homo androgynous, that people had once been an androgynous single sex and had changed over time into male and female. Humans were bisexual because we were joined, and like the pedunculated plants, of both sexes. And later, when Darwin popularized his theory of natural selection, we started to wonder if maybe species had originated evolutionarily as a single sex, and research shows that very well may have been the case. But the bisexual homo androgynous obviously doesn't refer to the minority group we now refer to as bisexuals, or omnisexuals, or pansexuals, or polysexuals, or fluid, or abrosexuals. You get the idea. For that, we journey to Germany. Karl Heinrich Ulrichs was a lawyer, and what we might now call a gay rights activist, though at the time we didn't have the words for that. Obviously gay sex and gay love were happening in the world and always had been, but the names to distinguish people who partook in those behaviours as a minority group did not. So Ulrichs didn't really have the words to describe what he was, something he felt he was born with and was innate. So he did what anyone with a Tumblr would do in that situation. He made the words up. According to Plato's Symposium, the god Uranus created Aphrodite on his own, a male giving birth to love without a female partner. And that is where Ulrich's term for what we now call a gay man comes from. Urning, or Uranian. The word for a lesbian was then Urningin. However, there was another story of Aphrodite where she was born of Zeus and Dione, so Dioning became the word for a straight man, Dioningin for straight woman. And Ulrichs also recognized that there were people who could not be characterized in either of these ways, and they became Uranodioning and Uranodioningin. The normal man he calls Dioning, the abnormal man Urning. Men who seem to be indifferently attracted to both sexes he calls Uranodionings. Uranodionism is what we might call bisexuality. So contrary to popular belief, the earliest of these distinctions were actually named by an activist for activism and not initially pathologized. Ulrich saw his Uranism as having a female mind born into a male body, a distinction which would confuse the hell out of modern activists. So I guess that made bisexuals, or Uranodionings, perhaps not unlike the homo androgynous, both male and female. The word homosexual was later coined by Austrian writer Karl Maria Kertbeny in 1868 in a letter to Ulrichs, and later became the more prominent word in the public discourse. In the 1880s, Richard von Krafft-Ebing published one of the first texts on sexual pathology. He utilized Ulrich's theory, but concluded that homosexuality was a form of mental illness. Krafft-Ebing added bisexuality in the 1890s for the 7th edition of the book, and that is when bisexual, in this context, entered into the English language. Though Krafft-Ebing did consider homosexuality, and by extension bisexuality, to be a mental illness, he did actually support decriminalization. You can't help someone who is sick by turning their illness into a crime. Ultimately, Krafft-Ebing did come around to be more supportive as time went on. And then there was Freud. Freud talked about bisexuality similarly to how a 14-year-old bisexual with a MySpace might have. Like, yeah, I mean, like, basically everyone's bisexual. It's just, like, life makes you more sort of gay or straight, but really, like, everyone is kind of bisexual. He still thought we should aspire to heterosexuality and that anything else was an unfortunate deviation from the ideal. To be cured of homosexuality wasn't actually to become straight, but to be bisexual. The goal was to make heterosexuality possible rather than getting rid of homosexuality. Like other dudes mentioned, Freud didn't believe that homosexuality should be criminalized. It seems like understanding gay and bisexual people led to some degree of sympathy even from the people who pathologized it. But where Freud was a little more vague on his thoughts on bisexuality, Austrian psychologist Wilhelm Steckel was just outright like, "Nature has created us bisexual beings and requires us to act as bisexual beings." Whoa, that is hashtag problematic. Wilhelm, you are cancelled. Still, the word bisexual wasn't very commonly used in the mainstream. Obviously, it wasn't bisexuality that was criminalized, it was homosexuality, so the word bisexual was not in as common use. Sex researcher Alfred Kinsey invented the popular Kinsey scale in the 1940s, which measures attraction ranging from same sex to other sex, 0 being exclusively heterosexual attraction, 6 being exclusively homosexual attraction, and combinations of the both being everywhere in between. This has become really popular over the years for explaining and understanding bisexuality as a spectrum. However, Kinsey never used the word bisexual because it was just too confusing. Until it is demonstrated that taste in a sexual relation is dependent upon the individual containing within his anatomy both male and female structures, or male and female physiological capacities, it is unfortunate to call such individuals bisexual. The reason Kinsey was convinced bisexual was a ridiculous and confusing word is that earlier definitions of bisexual were still in use, such as in Bisexual Man or Evolution of Sexes, on how we all evolved from bisexual man, which meant we were actually all one sex but evolved or devolved into two, like homo androgynous. And don't forget the first, and I think only, use of the word bisexual in Star Trek was in 1967, referring to the Tribbles who reproduced asexually or bisexually. Obviously, if the word bisexual had been more popularly used in the sense of sexual orientation at the time, the Tribbles probably wouldn't have been referred to as bisexual, but Captain Kirk definitely would have. So bisexual was still being used to mean a kind of person or life form of both male and female sexes, and this wasn't actually distinguished in many cases from the sexuality itself, as many of the aforementioned figures believed that homosexuality was having, for instance, a female brain and a male body, which meant a bisexual was both male and female, and their sexuality and gender were both part of the same thing. A more common association during the mid-20th century for bisexual had nothing to do with sexuality at all, but meant unisex. For instance, a handsome hat might be bisexual. Oh dear, what a lovely hat, we could both wear it. Bisexual. Bisexual. Adjective. 1. Possessing characters of or sexually oriented towards both sexes. 2. Of, relating to, or involving two sexes. So as we see here, the word could still mean simply involving two sexes. If there were both men and women at a party, the party was a bisexual party. And of course in those days, orgy simply meant drunken revelry. So if you ever find yourself time traveling back to the mid-20th century and you get invited to a bisexual orgy, be prepared for disappointment. But the sexual orientation definition was pretty straightforward. Notice that it didn't refer to gender, only sex. The modern concept of gender was still in its very early stages of evolution. This definition definitely came from the works of folks like Krafft-Ebing and Freud, and not from what we might now describe as the LGBT community. And while the mainstream may not recognize bisexuality as a sexual orientation, the gay and lesbian communities were beginning to recognize a distinct group called bisexuals by at least the 1950s. Another sort of lesbian is the so-called bisexual. In gay circles, she is said to be double-gated. Straight society often describes her as an oversexed female bordering on, if not actually suffering from, nymphomania. She is thought to be half and half, and often presumed to be extremely promiscuous. The bisexual lesbian is indeed often love-hungry, not necessarily because her appetite is any larger than other females, but more often because she is allergic to all sexual food. Both women and men give her indigestion in the form of guilt, and yet, despite the consequences, she is addicted to the very thing she is allergic to. A refreshing dose of biphobia for you. Stephen Donaldson, aka Donnie the Punk, was a bisexual activist who founded the first student gay rights group in 1967, 2 years before the revered Stonewall Riots. The 70s and 80s saw bisexual organizations popping up all over the place, including the San Francisco Bisexual Center, the annual bisexual conference BiCon in the UK, which is still going on today, and the Boston Bisexual Women's Network. And of course, we all know Brenda Howard was one of the original Pride Parade organizers back in 1970. In popular culture, certain androgynous celebrities were beginning to identify as bisexual, to which the media responded, "What? What does that mean? Are you gay?"
You've been asked the question whether you're bisexual or not.
Too many times.
Yes, and you've never quite answered it.
Oh, I have. I said I was bisexual, that's enough.
Does that mean, though, that you really are, or does that mean that you're keeping some kind
of... I've answered the question.
Right, okay.
And over the following decades, bisexuals began to explore exactly what it meant to be bisexual. Unlike the dictionary definition, their answer wasn't quite so clear. Jay, are we ever going to be able to define what bisexuality is? S. Never completely, that's just it. The variety of lifestyles that we see between us defies definition. Being bisexual does not mean that they have sexual relations with both sexes, but that they are capable of meaningful and intimate involvement with a person regardless of gender. Bisexual usually implies that relations with gender minorities are possible. Is bisexuality a third kind of sexual identity, between or beyond homosexuality and heterosexuality? Or is it something that puts in question the very concept of sexual identity in the first place? In the current debate on sexual orientation, there is only room for two positions, gay or straight. Within this framework, bisexuality appears not as an identity, but as the absence of one. We are the excluded middle, the position of preferring nothing. We are a failure of sexual identity. But of course, to the world at large, the strange nature of the bisexual was that they were both gay and straight, into men and women, and that was what bisexual meant to most people. Despite the work bisexuals were putting into their activism, that didn't mean the mainstream was really recognizing bisexuality as an alternative option for sexual orientation or lack thereof. The credit for bringing bisexuality into the mainstream really goes to the HIV crisis of the 1980s. Bisexuals were really thrown under the bus as vectors, as traitors, bisexual men in particular, who were allegedly transmitting AIDS, a gay virus, to straight women. In reality, HIV was more commonly entering into the straight world via intravenous drug use, but the idea that drug addicts were at risk wasn't going to convince the average straight person to care about HIV. In all honesty, HIV needed to begin posing a threat to good, innocent, straight people in order for the world to start caring about stopping it. While it had only been a gay disease, it could kill off the gays and no one would care, but the threat of bisexuality meant that it wasn't going to stay safely segregated. Bisexual people were going to kill straight people. The media began warning straight women of the danger of bisexuals. Cosmopolitan ran an article in 1989 warning straight women of the signs that their partners might be a secret bisexual. And that is when bisexual, in the modern sense, really entered the public lexicon. So bisexuals entered the public consciousness not as a valid minority group seeking equal respect and rights, but as cheating, two-faced sluts preying on innocent straight women. It seems that even some people in the lesbian community felt that bisexual women were going to bring AIDS into their spaces. It's likely that even now our attitudes towards bisexuals are influenced by this time when the mainstream really saw bisexuals as the ultimate traitors. But of course, since then, we have come up with many words to describe this vague concept of bisexual attraction, such as pansexual, which had referred to the BDSM community for the last few decades of the 20th century, but which people were starting to use synonymously with bisexual in the early 21st century, and other terms which included omnisexual, trisexual, polysexual, fluid, and plenty more. All the same, activists made a point of saying, yes, okay, all words are valid, but let's use bisexual as an umbrella term so that we continue the work and organize. We had to fight for decades just to get the B into LGBT. It's difficult to win a fight when you can't even agree on language. In 2020, the Merriam-Webster dictionary updated bisexual to include of, relating to, or characterized by sexual or romantic attraction to people of one's own gender identity and of other gender identities. The significance of this revolves around a shift in our concept of what gender even is. Where we started back in the 18th century talking about sexual, not meaning sexy times, but referring to biological sex, the new definition of bisexual doesn't even refer to sex at all, but to gender. Gender, as we know it today, did not exist in the 19th century. Krafft Ebing probably wouldn't have a clue what we meant by gender versus sex. Also, the word sex has changed. 200 years ago, it would have referred not to the act of sex, but to the dangly and not so dangly bits you had on your body. The idea that sexual now refers to who I want to have sex with is kind of new. And on top of that, the sexual side is often presumed, quite rightly so, to refer not only to sexual attraction, but to romantic attraction. So the idea of bisexuality referring to the gender of the person one is sexually and romantically attracted to is a pretty significant change. The very concept of bisexuality 100 years before was based in the idea that a bisexual person was by nature physically both male and female sexes. Now we're not even talking about sex at all, and when we do talk about sex, we're talking more often about doing the dirty. So where did this change come from? The last few decades have brought to light new concepts of alternative gender identities to simply man and woman. This isn't about maleness or femaleness, but about manness and womanness, the combination thereof, or the lack thereof. You may have someone whose sex characteristics were typically male to begin with, but their gender identity is a woman, or could even be neither man nor woman. Case in point, there has been a lot of discourse over the last decade or two as to who could possibly be attracted to a freak like me, where obviously the answer is everybody. But there was a controversy. Could all bisexuals really like someone androgynous? A homo-androgynous even? Could a bisexual really see anything beyond the most traditional conservative Christian roles of man and woman? For some people, the answer appeared to be absolutely not. Bisexual is a fixed word with an absolute meaning and cannot and has never been changed. The prefix was just too stressful for some people to handle, even while the meaning of the root and suffix was very much in flux. They declared that actually bisexuality was extremely exclusionary of everyone except vaginas in high heels and penises with mustaches. If you didn't change your sexual orientation right away, you were a traitor to the LGBT community. However, the activist community never really bought into that, having often made space for and welcomed trans people. And so it came to pass that activists had adequately badgered Merriam-Webster dictionary until the dictionary was like, oh, okay, fair enough. The new definition vaguely tries to pay tribute to the bi prefix, but in a way which essentially means regardless of gender. When it comes to bisexuality, the gender of the object of affection is up for grabs, and of course bisexual can refer to a person of any gender. Some folks and some activists now even prefer to shorten bisexual to simply bi, seeing bi to gay as bisexual is to homosexual. Bi is a cool, casual, non-clinical term, which is wild because bi in the original Latin means two, so if you take it literally it's saying I am two, but really it's referring to so, so much more than that. And that's how the evolution of language goes, really. So in a way, it's like we've come full circle. The word bisexual, once referring to homoandrogynous, someone both and neither male or female, with no concept of straight or gay, and in some ways, this is where we are now. Bisexuality as freedom from the confines of gender and sex, and sexual and romantic attraction. I think at the end of the day, it's important to look back and respect the etymological root of a word, which is why, for me personally, I identify as a pedunculated homoandrogynous plant. And so can you. Special thanks to Susie S, Nina, and Aaron for supporting this video. If you would like to see your name up here too, or just want to support my videos anonymously, check out my Patreon, where you can also get some special treats. Please like and subscribe. And if you want notifications for my next videos, then hit the little bell as well to give you notifications. If you have any suggestions for videos you'd like to see on future topics, please let me know in the comments. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.